Welcome to the Gastric Health Show. My name is Dawn Boxall, and I am the host. And we are super excited to be recording again and providing some content hopefully you'll find valuable and beneficial to your journey after weight loss surgery. Today's topic is ditch the drink mix and drink this instead. So if you have followed me for any period of time, you know that I am not a big fan of artificial sweeteners. And this is the main flavoring in drink mixes. So if you don't mix in your water, some Crystal Light, sugar-free Kool-Aid, Powerade Zero, G2, any of those types of sweeteners, what do you drink? Okay, first off, what's wrong with drink mixes? So unfortunately, it is the artificial sweeteners. And many programs, doctors, dietitians still recommend utilizing these drink mixes in unlimited quantities and believe that they are fully safe, no consequences with drinking them. But looking at it from a functional nutrition perspective, I do see things a little differently. And I do believe that food is information. And everything that we put in our mouth is telling our cells and our genes what to do. Turn off diabetes, turn on cancer, any of those, you know, genetic predispositions we've been given through our family history, it's in us. It doesn't mean that it has to be fully developed and we actually get them. We get to choose by what we do with our diet and lifestyle. They are learning more and more every day that our diet and lifestyle truly does have an impact on what happens with our genes expressing disease states. So if you want to put the odds in your favor, it is about eating whole real foods and avoiding these type of products that can alter what you are really striving for. You're striving for health, you're striving for being at a normal weight and maintaining it, and long term, this may be compromised because of these artificial sweeteners. So, what's wrong with the artificial sweeteners? And I have done a few other podcasts on this. So if you want a deeper dive, I go into this a little bit more on my podcast, Are You in a Stall? Listen to this. How to overcome hunger and still lose weight. How to crush cravings and avoid regain. Those are three podcasts that can really look at different aspects of artificial sweeteners in regards to the topics I'm talking about. Weight stalls, weight loss, and cravings and regain. So this one is just really hitting the highlights that we're talking about today on drink mixes in particularly. So artificial sweeteners. It has been considered a safe food additive for years. But as the research has continued, the evidence is showing areas of concern. I mean, there are really good studies out there showing that, hey, you know, maybe we need to dial this back a little bit and rethink utilizing artificial sweeteners like many people do. So there are studies that show artificial sweeteners alter your microbial metabolic pathways, making you more susceptible to metabolic disease. So insulin resistance, diabetes, any of those types of metabolic diseases is really going to be impacted with artificial sweeteners. And because of the microbes that are in our gut naturally, and it alters them. So it sends different signals and different information to our microbes, as well as our genes, and that's where you have to be careful. It can also, artificial sweeteners have been known to induce dysbiosis or gut imbalances in our gut bacteria and glucose intolerance. They have found that when they take non-diabetics and they give all the participants were non-diabetics and they gave a group artificial sweeteners and a group no artificial sweeteners. And the ones that had the artificial sweeteners actually had higher blood glucose levels. So kind of interesting, as this is promoted as a safe food additive for diabetics. So you got to really think through, okay, maybe in the doses that I seem to find that weight loss surgery patients do at pretty high levels, is this really contributing? Is this a piece of why we see such regain and why we see diabetes come back or insulin resistance after a period of time? Also, artificial sweeteners can potentially stimulate food intake. So they have found, it is an animal study, but that it can stimulate your desire to eat more food. Your brain gets confused. It thinks that the sweetness, it thinks that it's going to get sugar and it will raise the blood sugar level. And when your blood sugar level does not go up, then it makes your body want more of that, of the sugars and the carbs and, you know, things that turn into sugar. So it could be breads, it could be crackers, it could be just any of those snacky carbohydrate-rich foods that are, you know, main craving that you're driven to eat. And it can really increase that desire because your brain is trying to get that blood glucose level up. So it's confused. It thinks it should already be up and it's not. So, oh, we must need some more sugar. So again, now we're craving more of those things that are not really helping us. Then there is a study, the San Antonio Heart Study, found that artificially sweetened beverages increased the risk of weight gain. And this was in normal to overweight individuals. It made them more prone to have a risk of gaining more weight. So that's concerning to me that, you know, we're allowing food additives that really alter our metabolic pathways. It's altering our gut bacteria, and it can increase the risk of weight gain. And that is not helpful after weight loss surgery. And that's where you have to make a choice. You have to decide what you're going to allow and what you're going to avoid, regardless of what your program says to some degree or what your doctor or dietitian is maybe even saying. Try it. See if it really makes a difference for you. I really don't believe anybody's going to drop 30, 40 pounds by going off of artificial sweeteners. I think it's the full body aspect. The inflammation is going to come down. Your gut microbes are going to be more balanced. So then it leads to, you know, less inflammation and a more normal weight and less weight fluctuations and less cravings and those. So in a sense, it's going to, impact your weight in that way. And lastly, the intense sweetness of the artificial sweeteners can surpass the cocaine reward even in drug-sensitized and addicted individuals. So they do find that artificial sweeteners are super addictive and have found that those studies where they can be already addicted to cocaine, but they will, instead of the cocaine, they will hit the artificial sweeteners. So kind of scary. So that's where people can feel like, I can't get off of this. I've tried not drinking even soft drinks. And I know weight loss surgery patients are not supposed to be drinking these, but do they? Absolutely. Unfortunately, we have many patients that will go back to drinking diet soft drinks and regular. But for the topic that we're on today, the artificial sweeteners, it's no, you know, Diet Coke, Diet Pepsi, Diet Sprite. Those are no different than Crystal Light or Powerade Zero or Sugar-Free Kool-Aid. They're all the same types of sweeteners utilized. I do find when I am counseling patients, the ones that drink large volumes of artificial sweeteners are more into the carbs and the sugars and struggle to get off of them, struggle to keep them in control and not binge on them and not have, a horrible time not eating them. So I think, you know, you do have to step back and say, okay, I had weight loss surgery for a reason. And it may have been your health was just miserable. You couldn't breathe. The risk of diabetes was there. Maybe you were already on insulin, or, you know, maybe it was, renal failure. Maybe it is high blood pressure, you name it. It could be any of those reasons why you wanted to have weight loss surgery, not just for, I wanted to fit in a certain size of jeans. Weight loss surgery is about the health aspect. Big picture. That's what you're doing this for. So you've got to step back and decide, okay, am I going to allow these food items to overtake what I know is going to compromise this life-altering surgery? I mean, we are changing your anatomy permanently. Your anatomy is never going to go back to its normal state. You can't take weight loss surgery lightly, and you have to think of all the things that can impact you staying on track and staying at a normal weight long term. So, and this could be one of the pieces. You maybe went from Mountain Dew to Diet Mountain Dew, and was that really any better for your health? I don't think so. You went from maybe Diet Coke to Crystal Light. Is that really any better? I don't think so. So if you want to go deeper in these topics, listen to those other podcasts. Are you in a stall? Listen to this. How to overcome hunger and still lose weight. How to crush cravings and avoid regain. Those are the three podcasts that I've already recorded quite a while ago on this that would really go in a little bit deeper on these studies. Now, I do want to say, I am very real. I try to have a very real perspective when it comes to food. So I do believe our bodies can handle small amounts of harmful things and still flourish. But how much is too much? And for me, this is how I base it. If I have a patient that's coming in and the majority of their fluids have some type of flavoring, artificial sweetener in it, I'm challenging them. I am challenging them to flip it. Some patients come in and they drink zero water, zero. They hate it, they say. So that's where you have to really work hard. I'm not going to tell you have to love water. I'm just going to tell you this is what your body needs. And you've got to figure out how you're going to get water in and not compromise all the hard work that you've put in by having this surgery. So if the majority of your fluids has some type of drink mix, and you have to remember your protein shakes are going to have some type of drink mixes or artificial sweeteners in it as well. So just step back and list protein shakes, Mio, Crystal Light, Gatorade, G2, Gatorade Zero, Powerade Zero, Vitamin Water Zero, all of those have artificial sweeteners. Plus, if you're doing sugar-free popsicles, sugar-free gelatin, that's a lot. So it can be in your foods. And then I know most people are aware of this, but you really shouldn't, after weight loss surgery, be consuming the sugar-free desserts, sugar-free Reese cups, sugar-free chocolates, sugar-free, I don't know, there's so many options out there. Baking mixes, all that stuff, those things would be lumped into this. So if you step back and look at what you do on a regular basis, you can probably identify that, hey, oh my gosh, I am consuming a lot of artificial sweeteners on a regular basis. So what do you drink? What do you do if you're not adding these artificial sweeteners? Because come on, this is the real world. And just because you had weight loss surgery doesn't mean you're not going to want to have some types of sweet things, dessert things, or flavorful beverages. Water does get boring. Water gets old to just drink plain. So you do have to get creative sometimes. So bottom line, ideally, we should all be drinking more plain water than we drink of any other fluid. So if you're not there, that's my challenge to you to work on it. Start with, I'm going to finish one water bottle every single day. And you don't change anything. You're just adding. You're adding a positive thing. I'm adding plain water. And if you totally hate plain water, add in a lemon wedge, add in some cucumbers. And you'll have a link. There's a recipe of spa water that I love at my house. Even my teenagers like it. And it has cucumbers, lemon, orange, and then mint leaves. And this is a great flavored water that you really don't need any sweetener to it. It has a natural sweetness. And I just leave it in the pitcher all week and keep filling up the water. Fill up the pitcher as it empties and add more to it. And at the end of the week, then I'll dump all the fruit and the cucumber out and move on to something different. But adding these natural fruits, vegetables, I don't care what ones you do. You don't have to count that. You don't have to be worried you're getting too much sugar from the fruit or too many carbs. That is not an issue at all. So find some infused water recipes, or another one is iced herbal teas. If you like tea, or if you've never really tried tea, I would encourage you to find a flavor that maybe sounds doable and brew it. I just make it in a saucepan, put like 6 or 8 tea bags in a saucepan with water, boil it for a little bit, and then put it in a pitcher, fill the rest up with water, and throw it in the fridge. And it's ready to go, and put ice over it, and you've got a great glass of tea that's refreshing and light, has a nice sweet flavor at times, depending on the flavors. I like a peach and raspberry one. You can do green teas. Green teas are great. They do have a smidge of caffeine, so you can't go crazy if you do have coffee, you know, caffeine from your coffee. You want to, you know, minimize the amount of caffeine you're getting because it can irritate that stomach lining and cause ulcers. But green tea is way, it's like a third of the caffeine compared to coffee. So it would be an option to have a green tea, even the non-decaf. But if you are caffeine sensitive, make sure you get the decaf green tea. So if you don't drink the drink mixes, I want you to do infused waters. I want you to do iced herbal teas. I want you to drink more plain water than you drink of anything else. And don't allow these artificial sweeteners to take over your gut bacteria, take over your taste buds, confuse your brain into thinking it needs more sugars and carbs just to function. So I hope I've given you something to challenge yourself with, something to think about, and maybe evaluate your own personal intake of. And hopefully this will give you a little kick in the pants to make that change if you haven't already. So have a great day. Bye-bye.